not a party. No. Mahi got it rocking. We bring havoc to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' copy because we poppin'. Blues up in my wallet. If I like it, then I cop it. Hold up, check me out. Hold up. I think the tables and turn. Forget the bridges we done built. It's time I let them all burn. They tried to count me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first. They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Just the perfect time of year for a trip to the Carolinas, and that's where we find ourselves at Bank of America Stadium at Uptown Charlotte. Just a moment ago, the lights, the cameras, the action, all the pyrotechnics, everything was ablaze, everything was allowed here in Bank of America Stadium as Carolina emerged from their tunnel. And we are ready to go as the Panthers get set to match up with the Tennessee Titans. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. Derek Barnett able to record his fifth sack of the season.
A lot of talk the other day about them wanting to quiet this home crowd early and often. Very first play of the game, they do just that.
You're exactly right about that, because that's often a conversation when you go on the road and you travel. Hey, let's take the crowd out of it. What a great way of doing so by putting the quarterback on the deck.
And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. On play action, they'll throw. And that was going to be off target and incomplete.
So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things, isn't he? But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on out there. And right now, he is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat, in every meeting with reporters this week? He kind of said, I've had enough, and I don't blame him. He looks like a guy that may very well be out the door.
They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. They'll look to throw here. And this is going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin them back. First carry for Derrick Henry. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. And we were down on the field watching Henry warm up before the game. He's a big man. No wonder he breaks those tackles.
And you remember what I told you when we were watching? It's not all pads. Yeah. I mean, you get him out of pads and just see him in a regular suit or an outfit, he is a huge human being and a lot faster than what people know. When he gets
Derrick Henry all alone. Touchdown, Titans! Derrick Henry, touchdown number 15 of the year. And the Titans, on just two plays, have taken the lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes the score 7-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. As we grind toward the end of the season here, and they haven't had the season that they had hoped. So let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think when you look into the upcoming draft, think hard about them drafting multiple offensive linemen. They've got to get stouter up front. And as a GM always tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league, and big people always end up winning games for you.
On second down, McCaffrey. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
So first and 10 now from the 30. This is McCaffrey on the give. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
And he's brought down after a very nice game.
Good, strong, explosive run that started inside, which means you've got to control those defensive linemen, the defensive tackles, the nose guards. Those guys have to be controlled. How about the offensive line, the job they just did?
Yeah, key that A-gap usually on those runs, right?
That's where it all starts, because everyone wants to kind of control that area. It disrupts things from the defensive side and the offensive side. As we just saw, it opens up possibilities. They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Over the middle, that's complete to McCaffrey. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 33.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Another run, this time McCaffrey. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Looking to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 17-yard line.
As a rookie quarterback, that's exactly how you endear yourself to your teammates. Give it up for the cause. It's also how you end up on the training table, too.
Yeah, it's a catch-22. Coach doesn't like it. Teammates love it. Where do you fall on it?
Well, I fall on wanting to endear yourself to your teammates. But pick your spots. Be smart about it. They need you for the full season.
Yeah, the rookie's going to learn as he goes. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
He's brought down to the 15-yard line. A gain of two brings up second and eight.
Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. Touchdown, Panthers! DJ Moore with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this off under a heavy rush, and down he goes. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down of the sack. Back quite a ways here, facing second and 19. Looking to throw. Miller. Got his man. That's the Pro Bowler, Julio Jones. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
On third down, Henry. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the close fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. These two teams all tied after one. On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. And it's a fake here on fourth and inches. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. Anxious moments there on the fake, but they do get just enough to pick up the first down. They'll get that one out quickly to Brown. Stop shy of the 45. Showed off a nice little move on the play, though. 7 yards to pick up there.
When you call a wide receiver screen, no matter how many blockers you get in front of the guy that catches the ball, there's still an aspect of the guy catching it turning into a runner, breaking tackles and creating his own yardage, and he just did on that play.
Oh, a nice spin.
Boom!
Still fighting through tackles. And he is finally going to be brought down, but not before he gets it to the Panthers 26.
114 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Off the play fake, Miller. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Back to throw, Miller. This will go to Henry out wide. That catch good for only a couple.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, It could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line.
He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. And we'll get a moment here as they look this one over.
Yeah, remember now, the call on the field is what they'll stick with unless they have clear video evidence to the contrary. And I give these officials a lot of credit. Such a tough and demanding job, you and I both know that. Yeah, they make the right call way more often than they get it wrong.
Well, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Now back to throw.
He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey.
And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
McCaffrey with a first down and more. And finally taken down at the 4-yard line.
He's had his eyes on 7,000 career rushing yards, and with that last effort, he has hit that mark. What a career.
And that is the number to focus in on, because oftentimes we talk about where do they rank all time. We're not there yet. He's not knocking on the top 10 or the top 20, but over 7,000 yards in a career, fantastic.
On first and goal, they'll try the option left. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down. They're going to look to throw. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8. Bud Dupree, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Carson. They wind up with 6 on the hook up there, but it's not enough. Fourth and goal.
A short game that doesn't get them the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it.
Gonzalez's kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7.
So they wind up turning the turnover into points as they convert there for 3.
Yeah, that was a nice job there to force the fumble. They recover, hand things over to their offense, and then the offense went down and got them 3. That alone, that's not enough to win a game, but both units able to do their jobs on these last 2 drives.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive.
And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part 2, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again. 2nd and 10 from the 25. Henry running right. Wiggles free. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
126 yards rushing for him so far in this one as he nears 1,400 for the year.
A solid run by Derrick Henry, and here's another 1st and 10. Looking to throw, Miller. Pressure comes in, he's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Hassan Reddick in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
Well, last game he had two sacks. Got another one here picked up right where he left off.
Brandon, he spent the entire offseason working on new moves, new techniques, trying to add to his arsenal of pass rush moves. Certainly paying dividends in what we've seen so far.
A handoff running left, Henry.
And he was able to shed one tackle but could not get away from there.
I think we can safely say that those types of players are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates are going to check on it because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen.
A big play that time through the air. 30 yards.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down.
He'll drop to throw. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers.
Christian McCaffrey
with his 16th touchdown of the year.
And the Panthers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Titans offense set to begin the drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Derrick Henry. Able to avoid him at the 40. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed. Running left, it's Henry. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Back to throw. Miller. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Brian Burns in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Hassan Reddick racking up sack number 12 for him on the year. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. So on fourth down, the Titans will turn it over to their punter since 2009, and that's Brett Kern. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the Panthers will take over now first and 10. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And with a little under a minute to go, still time to try to put a drive together to add to their lead, should they so choose. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it, and it's second down.
You know, if following up on this head coach and the pressure that he is under, CD, I want to switch it to you because you've been on winning teams, but I know you've been in similar situations too where things just are not going well. How do you approach that as a player?
It's a tough approach, Brandon, because you actually have to do the opposite of what you would think. You know, in your mind, you're thinking, I redouble my efforts, I go harder. In a sense, you have to back off a little bit. You have to do a little bit less. Do what you're supposed to do, but don't take on the pressures of doing more and trying to do your teammates' jobs as well. If you do that, that's really going to lead you to more issues.
Now, after the holding call, here's second and 20. He'll look to throw. Open man left side, it's the tight end Trimble. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. And now whistles here and a flag down. Looked like someone got going a little early. A false start backs him up five, first and 15. Back to throw here. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Give him 4 yards there, and that should be the final play of this first half. So we've reached halftime here on New Year's Eve as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Each team making their final preparations for this second half. We're about ready, too, as we'll send you back up to Charlotte and rejoin Brandon and Charles at Bank of America Stadium.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And right out of the gate, they face what you think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so. You know, they're down 2 scores. That's not the end of the world. It wasn't the strongest of first halves, but for them to start calling back, they've got to start putting a little pressure on that defense, start cutting into this deficit. You can't have 3 and outs and expect to get that done.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Off play action, Miller, he's going deep for Brown, and that is caught one-handed. Oh my, he pulled it in. A big connection on that one, 37 yards.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process, and really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. On second down, here's Henry. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line.
But think of it like you would a typical boxing match. The person that's on his heels and absorbing blows is having a tough time. And that's what's happening to the defense right now, because the offense is on his toes and punching. And there was another first down run right there.
This is Henry. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play there. Second down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
On second down, it's Henry. And he'll be out of bounds. 181 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
So a decent deficit at this stage in the second half, four down territory?
No doubt about it. There's not a chance that he hasn't looked ahead and said, okay, if we gain yardage on this play, this is what we'll do going forward. If we lose yardage, this is the play call that I'll have ready.
Touchdown, Derrick Henry. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Titans are able to make this a close game again. Point after here coming up. And this is up and good to make it a 17-14 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Back to throw. And he's got the hook up to Moore. Room here to run. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does. I'm getting a sense that the momentum of this game is changing since the break. Nice play there, and this D is fired up.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. He'll get about four as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
They'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
Amazing. Perfectly placed. If that ball goes one extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. They want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
Give him nine there on the first down completion.
Ready up.
Looking to throw on second down. Miller throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Looking to throw. Miller. And he'll get this underneath to Henry. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. 3 yards the gain there. Second down. A quick throw here out to Brown. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 12-yard line. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. They'll look to throw again. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Jackson puts it, and they'll be inside the red zone with a ball at the 16-yard line.
Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Ooh, the touchdown, Panthers! Tommy Trimble. His 9th touchdown of the season. And the Panthers use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They're down now 24-14. Work to do as they come up on a first and 10. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It's been a remarkable day at the office for him running the football. Those yards just continue to pile well past 100.
And how about more than double-digit carries in the second half alone? That's what you want as a runner, because you've got to prove to your offensive line that you're going to be as tough as they are. They don't rotate in and out on every play. Running backs often do, so those who can stay out there with their offensive linemen, those are the guys they really value.
And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Derrick Henry with touchdown number 3 here in this game and 17 now on the year. And the Titans have made this a 1-score game. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is down to a field goal. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be returned from deep in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Their lead down to a field goal now as they start with a first and 10. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
As they began this drive, it's wondering if they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Will they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Here's the option, and he'll lose yardage here back at the 41. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. And if they keep making plays just like that, they're going
to
give their
14 yards to go, second down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw.
And he slings one that's incomplete. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out. Yeah, let's get a sack lunch.